So I'm really interested to know with you guys, because I feel like sometimes I may be the only person in the world that actually seems to feel this way, and it drives me fucking crazy. Do you ever feel like there's maybe one champion in the game out of all the 126, 7 odd champions that you can choose from? You know all the spells of every character, you know how each character plays, you've poured hours and hours of your life into League of Legends, you have hundreds of games that can even go into the thousands over the years, and for some reason, there is just one champion that you just don't fucking get. A single champion that just plays a certain way, or has a certain spell or mechanic that you just can't seem to comprehend. Well, that is Zed for me. Zed to me is like an alien fucking language. It's like I am sitting at the negotiation table of an alien spacecraft, and some 11 foot Klingon looking ass motherfucker with spikes for arms and spikes for hands and spikes for fingers is tossing out what I can only fucking assume is supposed to be a language, even though it sounds like a series of farts and bowel movements. I know that my life depends on this. I know that my fate, and quite possibly the fate of the world and humanity, is resting on my ability to just fucking understand what the fuck I'm doing. Quite like the analogy that I used that kind of got away from me for a minute there. I have no idea what the fuck I'm doing with Zed. Okay, bottom line, Zed to me is just confusing, and I want to give you a fair warning that during the games that you're going to see in the background of this video, despite my efforts to only put in clips of me actually killing people, some people have brought it to my attention that my suckage is so horrible that it actually makes it impossible for them to concentrate on listening to the video, despite the fact that I'm not a pro player. I've never claimed to be a pro player. I actually openly admit that I'm crap at the game. I've played it for 5 years. I'm still terrible. I was gold last season. I'm a man child. I make jokes on League of Legends for a living, so you can go fuck yourself. So before you go, leave a comment like, "Russ Boom sucks. It was actually disgusting that at 604 in this video, you used your Q to secure kill when in fact you could have waited 2594 nanoseconds, to which you would have found that your W would have been off cooldown and you may have actually been able to have secured the kill as a whole lot better."
Regardless, you've been warned. If you've made it this far and you've got any plans to give me jip for how terrible I am in a comment, you might as well just leave your address, because I will personally come to your fucking house and Batista bomb your mother through a fucking dining table. But if you're like that and you're an asshole, I made sure to get one of the only Zed mains on Earth who isn't Korean to come and help me out and give me some actual real insight into his favorite character. He is the highly skilled, highly educational Red Mercy. So what exactly did you think about Zed?
Why I hate Zed? Well, where to begin? He's got crazy mobility, he has an instant kill ultimate, he's impossible to catch, he has a fuckload of damage on his Q, his passive deals more magic damage than any ultimate, his laning phase is way too damn overpowered, and I have to build specific items just to counter him? I don't know, man, feels like I'm facing some damn Super Saiyan when fighting Zed with him teleporting around everywhere. Just kidding.
I heard that last part. Red Mercy, more like Zed Mercy.
Mauler, start talking, please.
Fucking Zed. Pretty sure they released this guy in the most bottom of the barrel move to be cool. Oh, look at me, I'm Zed, I'm covered in metal, metal's cool. I have assassin blades like Ezio and Assassin Creed. That's also cool. Hey, how about some shadow gimmick to make me seem even cooler? Wait, that Batman movie had some weird voice modulation for its villain, how about that as well? Plus a deep voice and voila, we have an automatically super cool champion that's totally not lame and easy to use. I mean, my goodness, even I can do his voice.
You see, it's not that hard, but it's practically a get-out-of-jail-free card for cool.
Yeah, the last thing I want to do is permanently sound like that ass-holy gravelly-ass shredder knockoff. Look, people, it's not cool to be like Zed. He's a twat. Get over it.
Well, everyone, that's enough prelude to the video. Let's get right into the video!
Oh, that's right. I almost forgot. If you're expecting any of those unseen blade is the deadliest jokes, then you can just fuck off, can't you?
So Contempt for the Weak is Zed's passive spell. And if I'm actually being completely honest with you, this entire time I've been playing Zed, right up until the point I wrote the script for this video. It didn't even occur to me that Zed actually even had a passive. I just assumed that Riot had kind of worked backwards on this character. They started from his ulti and they worked moving through his spells. And by the time they actually got to his passive, they were like, that'll do, fuck it lads. You want to go for lunch? So the passive empowers all of Zed's basic attacks, meaning that if they are below 50% of their max health, a single basic attack will deal up to 10% of the target's max health as magic damage. It can only occur on the same target every 10 seconds, but holy fuck if this isn't ridiculously strong anyway. Basically, if you're even remotely low health, you can't come within arm's length of Zed without being pimp slapped into the underworld.
Political analysts say this may be too little, too late.
Hi, I'm with the Port Commission.
Yeah! I'm from the Athlete's Foot Foundation.
Brother, hey, can you get my demo tape to somebody?
It does deceptive amounts of damage though, and if you're lucky enough, you can catch enemies off guard and plummet their health faster than the Fine Brothers subscriber count. Is that still relevant? Mom, is that, are Fine Brothers relevant?
No, honey, you're fucking late to the joke.
Ah, son of a bitch. So Zed's W is Living Shadow, and since it's a spell that is pretty essential to all of his other spells, I'm going to explain it first. Its passive is that it passively gives you up to 25% bonus AD, which isn't a crazy amount, but fuck if it don't help with that late game scaling, boy! The active, however, is that Zed projects his own shadow out of his body that then proceeds to mimic and reproduce a shadow version of the skills he casts, which, if they hit an enemy champion, can restore some of the energy he spends casting to Zed. And if he wants, he can cast his ability again, which causes Zed to blink to the shadow, meaning that he turns into a slippery little shit with this ability to juke you around like Sonic the Hedgehog covered in anal lube. Zed's Q is Razor Shuriken, and fuck if this skill don't make you want to go outside and start running around on the trees like motherfucking Naruto Uzumaki finna become the next Hokage, throwing razor blades at the neighbor's dog. And then getting grounded because mom says you can't throw razors at people until you finish your homework. On cast, Zed throws out two spinning blades in a straight line that go through every single target, dealing 100% damage to the first target and 60% to every target hit thereafter. Using this with your W means that you throw another set of shurikens from your shadow's location but from a different angle, meaning that you can get up inside your enemy's head and mindfuck them. And if you hit both shurikens, it deals additional damage and gives you some lovely energy back. Plus, hell, it's a 6-second cooldown that does pretty decent damage. So honestly, even if you're falling behind a Zed, just chill the fuck back. Use your Q to farm minions. Sure, you'll fall behind a little bit, but it's a good way of not getting absolutely obliterated at any given moment. Now, Zed's E is Shadow Slash, and it's a neat little spell, I'm not gonna lie, but to be honest, I always feel like it's underwhelming as fuck, and when I play Zed, I wanna throw shurikens around like pew pew pew, but for some reason this spell just doesn't give me the same satisfaction. Now on paper it sounds fantastic. Zed spins around, hitting every nearby enemy with his blades. For every champion hit with this, the cooldown of your W, your shadow, is reduced by 2 seconds, so fuck being careful, what are you waiting for, man? Get your ass in that team fight and smash that motherfucking like button! Yeah, smash that motherfucking like button. Wait, did I say like button? Fuck! So yeah, it slows the enemy for up to 40%, and hell, if you manage to hit them with your Living Shadow's E, then it can slow them for up to 90%, but I think the fact that your shadow deals no extra damage on this spell, it just kind of makes me feel like it doesn't really hit as hard as you want it to. I mean, you hit an enemy with two shurikens and you're like, fuck, you know? But with this, you're kind of like,
oh, yeah!
Now, Deathmark is Zed's ultimate, and holy fucking balls, this is pretty much the spell I am describing when I say I have no idea what I am doing with Zed. But apparently, it doesn't even really matter. You slap this spell on basically anyone you feel doesn't deserve to live any longer, and watch them hopelessly flail around trying to avoid inevitable death. You just press the R button and then... and that's it. Their name's in the death note, and it's quite literally just a matter of time. You're sitting there just waiting for the final tick to hit them like...
So when you cast this spell, you blink to the enemy target, becoming untargetable for almost a second, marking them and ghosting yourself for 3 seconds. At the end of the 3 seconds, the mark triggers, dealing 100% of your AD damage and up to 45% of the damage you dealt to the target whilst they had the mark on them. Meaning that if you can just get an enemy from 100% health to maybe like 55% health in the space of 3 seconds, which as a fucking assassin is not exactly difficult, this champion will cease to exist. And I want to show you something, alright guys? Right now. And I want you to help me recreate the sound that champions make when you play Zed, okay? Now don't call me crazy. Bear with me. Right, okay, try this, okay? Now take your pointer finger, alright? Now I want you to stick your pointer in your mouth. And I want you to press it against the inside of your cheek, okay? Like this. And then try and stiffen your mouth up. Like you're trying to stop your finger from escaping. And then push your finger out. Okay, this is the sound enemies are gonna make. This coupled with your living shadow basically means even if carries that you're going for are surrounded by teammates, if you happen to be quick enough, you can tower dive or dive onto carries, obliterate them in a split second, and then juke your enemies away from where you ulted from, which means that when you press your ulti again, you are now right back where you began, which happens to be away from all the danger. Getting juked by a Zed is the most frustrating fucking thing in the world, and I am pretty sure that the Mercurial Scimitar was actually only created to stop him getting a fucking 100% win rate and killing me every single time I try fucking do anything. The unseen joke is deadliest. Alright then, well thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Why I Hate. You might have noticed at, you know, the little eye at the top right of your screen, you can click. And it can give you a couple of voting options, which means that you can vote for the next Why I Hate episode. Thank you to everyone who has continued to support me by signing up to Crunchyroll with the web address crunchyroll.com/RussBimSocks. Big, massive shout out for helping continue to support my channel. You are collectively helping the wheels turn in this channel, and it's because of you that I'm able to continue doing what I'm doing. So recently, I've just finished watching Parasite. And I think that if you guys are into violent anime, then you are going to very much like this. You can watch it on Crunchyroll in 1080p, fully subtitled, alongside a bunch of these things called simulcasts that are basically where they import shows from Japan and they subtitle them and translate them as early as 1 hour after they actually air in Japan. So you can watch this on Crunchyroll, but Parasite is basically a show about this kid called Shinichi who gets infected by this shape-shifting worm that tries to take over his brain, and it only manages to invade his arm, and it eventually gets called Migi. And the anime revolves around this school kid whose entire morality is kind of being pulled into question. He doesn't want to kill people, he doesn't want people to be hurt, but the parasite in his right arm is focused solely on survival and keeping Shinichi alive and protecting him from the other aggressive alien beings, the other parasites that want him dead. It's hella violent. It's not that long, it's only got 24 episodes. It kind of has a weird dubstepy soundtrack. It's actually pretty okay, actually. I'm surprised to actually like it. And some pretty cool fights in it as well, so go check it out if you want by clicking the link to crunchyroll.com/RussBimSocks in the description and search for Parasite at the top right of the screen. Once again, thank you guys so much for watching. Subscribe and like the video and have a good day. See you guys later.